thank you, God. We worship you, Lord God. We honor you, Lord God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Please don't remember. Please remember to bring a friend on Thursday night. I don't know who was at the service last year. Regina. You're there? I think, yeah, you guys came last year. Yes. We had an awesome, awesome time. So come on, let's party together in the house of God. That's the best party. You can go home without a drink in your system.
Hallelujah.
We're going to be jamming. Oh, yeah, the Holy Ghost party.
That's the Holy Ghost party.
Yeah. Come on, come meet Jesus.
Come on.
Yes. This is going to be a good party. Good party.
Amen.
As we welcome our pastor.
Amen.
Pastor Mike, once the mic is in. Amen.
Amen.
How y'all feel?
Fired up.
How y'all feel?
Fired up.
How y'all feel?
Fired up.
Who we gonna beat?
The devil.
The devil.
Who we gonna beat?
The devil.
What's our number?
One.
Amen. Good afternoon. God bless you. Jesus is definitely in the building. Amen. All hats off.
All hats off.
Pastor Mo, you good? Good to see you, bro. Love you, bro. Let me see you smile, man. I love it when you smile. Such an awesome man of God, man. I truly love you, man. I thank God for you. Every morning I hear your voice in the prayer line, I just truly thank God. I actually wait to hear your voice. I'm going to actually stop speaking until I hear you. Because I know you get up early. You know, you got to seek God early. The Bible says, seek me while I may be found.
Amen.
Meaning, he might not always be there when you think he's going to be there. He's not at your beck and call. Even though he said, I'll never leave you or forsake you, there might be a season when you don't hear his voice. Yeah. The book of Amos says there's going to be a season where you won't hear I won't give you a famine of food and of drink. He said, I'll give you a famine of my word. Meaning, I might stop talking to you. Mm-hmm. You might start actually not hearing my voice. That's a scary day when you can't hear the voice of God. That's a lonely day when you can't hear the voice of God. No matter how much you love people, it's more important that you hear the voice of the Lord.
Amen.
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 It's more important. The Bible says a righteous man's steps are ordered by the Lord, or directed by the Lord, or guided by the Lord. That's why you see so many tears that were in the building today, because you hear somebody, you feel people that are being pulled to the Lord, and the Lord said something. I don't know what he said to you, woman of God, but whatever he said, I know it was good, because you started crying. That's how you know the presence of God is upon your life, when you start to cry. The Bible says even Jesus wept, because he was overcome with emotion. He knew God was saying something, and God was saying, oh my God, I feel, come on, just stay with me. Even when Lazarus was dead, the Bible said Jesus wept. But I believe when Jesus wept, he wasn't crying because Lazarus was dead. He was crying because I believe he was crying because God was speaking to him, saying, don't worry, son, I'm going to raise him through your power. So y'all ain't talking to me.
Amen.
But the Bible says when Jesus saw Lazarus was dead, he began to weep.
Amen.
But I believe he was weeping because he said, wow, God, can I really raise this man from the dead through my voice and through my word in the name of Jesus? And like Obama said, yes, you can.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, you can. That's what Obama's slogan was. Yes, you can.
Amen.
And when you got the power of God in the name of Jesus, you can do anything that you speak out of your mouth.
Amen.
The dead will raise up. The blind eyes will be opened up in the name of Jesus. You can call those things that be not as though they are. I don't know why we got so many quiet Christians in the building. You got to speak those things. You got to call those things. You got to pull those things out. The Bible says whatever you loose in heaven shall what? Be loose on earth.
Amen.
That means you got to use your voice. That song says lift up your voice and what? Sing. You got to lift up your voice and loose those things that you know God promised you.
Amen.
God made some promises to some people,
yes,
and they ain't here because you ain't loose your voice. I'm going to loose my voice.
Amen.
I'm going to open my mouth. I'm going to declare and decree what thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
I'm going to call down my peace. I'm going to call down my joy.
Yes.
I'm going to call down my blessing, and ain't nothing going to stop me.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
Thank you. Preach.
Thank you, Jesus.
Woo.
Jay-Z said it. He said, I got to get what? My soul right. I got to get these devils out of my life. You got to begin to open your mouth in the name of Jesus so you can get your soul right in Jesus' name. Come on, I wish I had somebody who was trying to get right in 2016. I got to get my soul right. I don't know about you. I don't know about you. Maybe you got it together. I got to get my soul right. I got to get them demons out of my what? My life in the name of Jesus. Y'all ain't helping me today. I got to get my soul right. He said, it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. Not just because I got a Bible, not because I got a microphone. It's me, oh Lord. I need you, Father. I need your power. I need your presence. In the name of Jesus, I got to get my soul right.
Come on, preacher.
I'm quiet up in here. Y'all must got it all together. Y'all must be all fixed up. Jesus must already be done with you. But I'm telling you something. If you know like I know, you'd be screaming, standing to your feet. I got to get my soul right. I got to get them devils and demons out my life. Open up that door, man of God. Y'all quiet like y'all got it all together. I don't know who really y'all at. I got to get my soul right. I got to get them demons out my life. I got to get them out, and I got to get them out when? Right now. Authority over every demonic spirit, over every spirit of hatred, bitterness, frustration, fear, envy, doubt. I gotta get my what? Soul right. I gotta get my what? Soul right. And I gotta do what? Gotta give these devils and demons what?
Out my life.
Come on, preacher. Y'all ain't loud enough for me. I'm telling you, I got some stuff in me. I got some junk in my trunk. And every day the Bible says, gotta crucify and mortify the deeds of the flesh. That means you gotta get your soul right. Get this thing out of my life, Jesus. Get this thing out of my heart, Jesus. I don't want to forgive. They didn't hurt me too bad. I don't want to give. I don't want to bless. I don't want to love. It don't feel good to love. If I love somebody, they won't love me back. That's a demonic spirit. I gotta get my what? Soul right.
Amen.
Jesus said, I didn't come for the righteous. I came for those who want to get what? My soul right. That's who I came for. I came for those people that are broken, that are hurt, that have been crying all morning, that got pulled into the house of God by the Spirit. And you can cry all day long because you're trying to get what? Your soul right. So you can get them demons what? Out my
life.
That's right. That's right.
Maybe it's just me, Duran. Maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm the only one, Jerry. Maybe I'm the only one that got some dark spots somewhere. The Bible says you got to mortify the deeds of the flesh. That means you got to examine yourself to see if you be in faith. And when you stand before the presence of God, ain't nobody else in that mirror. It's only you and God. It's only him and you. It's just me, oh Lord, what? Standing in the need of prayer. And I need it. The Bible says when he talked to Peter, he said, Peter, you don't even know it. He said, Satan asked or desired to sift you like wheat. You had no idea. You was busy working. You was busy hanging around. You was busy in fornication. You didn't know what was going on, Peter. The devil had a shotgun aimed at your head and you never saw it. He said, but I what? I prayed.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on. I got tears coming down my eye. God telling you, he said, I prayed for you.
Thank you, Jesus.
He said, the devil has asked to sift you. Like we, how long did Jesus wait before he told the devil no? How long did Jesus wait before he told the devil no? Some of us have committed so much stuff. We've been so disobedient. I'm sure Jesus wanted to be like, go ahead and touch him. Go ahead and afflict him. But it was something about Peter. It was something about the man of God. Jesus saw something in him. And Jesus said, I got to do something. I'm not going to let you kill him. I'm not going to let you hurt him. I'm not going to let you destroy him. He said, because Peter had his, he was trying to get what? His soul right. Jesus said, I pray for you so you can get them demons what? Out your life. Some of y'all too comfortable with devils and demons. Y'all too comfortable with fear. Some of y'all too comfortable with sickness and disease and poverty. Ain't you tired of being broke? Ain't you tired of doing them from check to check? I gotta get what? My soul right. Your prosperity might be tied all up in you getting your soul right. Come up in the house of God, won't stand up, won't smile, won't speak to nobody. The devil is a liar. Not in this building. We're going to praise God. We're going to give him glory in the name of Jesus. I don't care how I felt when I came in the building. Now that I'm here, I'm going to give him glory. Walking fear, I came to get what? My soul right.
That's right.
Preach. Ain't no reason to come up in the building still angry, still mad, still frustrated, still bitter. You in the house of God where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's a fullness of joy.
That's right.
And y'all ain't gonna say nothing. But
right.
I ain't worried about none of y'all. I gotta get what?
My soul right.
Y'all can act like y'all all right. No. When you come in this house, the Bible says when they saw God, they just fell down in his presence. It's something about the name Jesus that make you weak at the knees. I'm telling you, it's something about the name Jesus that give you goosebumps. It's something about the name Jesus that make you want to stand up all night. It's something about Jesus that make you want to cry out in the name of Jesus. I don't care what kind of problems you came with. You got Jesus in the building. I don't care what kind of situation you got. You got Jesus in the building. I don't care what kind of fear you got. You got Jesus in the building. I don't care what kind of bitterness you came in with. You got Jesus in the building. And if you would just tell God in the name of Jesus, Lord, help me get my what?
Soul right. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Holy Ghost.
And when you get your soul right, guess what's going to leave? Guess what's going to happen? Them demons going to what? Get out my life. Some of us just too comfortable.
Too comfortable.
We know he's a deliverer. We know he's a healer. We know he's a provider. We know he's a perfecter. We know that he will give us everything. We know he'll supply all of our needs. But he's also a demon destroyer. He's also come to cast out sin. So we don't want that Jesus. We want the lover. We want the provider. The one that'll meet all of our needs. The one that'll pay all of our bills. But we don't want that, the one that say, I gotta get that demon out your life. And I know you ain't gonna like it, but I'ma do it in the name of Jesus. That's what he said in the book of Mark, chapter 5. He told them demons, get out!
Come on, get out!
He said, what? Get out!
Come on, Pastor.
We don't want that Jesus. We don't want that Jesus that'll chase out sin. We don't want that Jesus. We want the loving Jesus. But the same lover is the same fighter. He's a lover and a fighter. But he ain't going to love you until he fight that demon out your life. Because he know you ain't going to do it. You kind of like that demon. Eminem said it. He said, I'm living with a what? A monster that's under my bed. Come on, y'all ain't talking to me. Eminem made a whole song about it. He said, I'm living with a monster that's under my bed. Can't get these voices out of my head. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing to me. See, that's how I know when the devil done got some of y'all. When your mouth, when you can't open your mouth. Listen, I gotta get my soul right, George. I don't know about them, babe. Give me some love. I gotta get my soul right. I gotta get them demons what? Out of my life.
That's right. That's right.
See, it's the demon that'll stop you from getting married. It ain't the woman. It's the demon. You can't see past the fault in the woman. The demon is the one that stands in the middle. The woman is fine. Ain't no wrong with the woman. But it's that demon you see. It's that demonic spirit you see. When you cast out the demonic spirit, oh my God, yo, she look good. Y'all ain't talking to me. It ain't the man. It ain't the man. It's the demon in front of the man that you looking at. That's why the Bible says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 18, he said, you come face to face with God. Move that demon out the way, devil. Y'all ain't talking. Move the demon out the way so I can really see what my wife look like. Move the demon out the way so I can see the good in my husband. Move the demon away so I can see the blessing behind the curse. Y'all ain't talking to me now. Move the demon away. I gotta get what?
My soul right.
Soul right, God.
It ain't the situation, it ain't the circumstance. It's what? I gotta get my soul right. If you just get your soul right, it don't matter. The Bible already told you, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. What you worried about? But you gotta get what? Your soul right. I don't care what happened. It ain't you, man of God. I gotta get what? My soul right. I gotta
right. That's right. No man.
We gonna go to 2016 fired up.
Fired up.
How y'all feel?
Fired up.
How y'all feel?
Fired up.
You gotta get what?
Fired up.
I gotta get what?
My soul right.
And then what's gonna happen? I'm gonna get them demons what? Out of my life.
Out.
Jesus.
But sometimes you can't see it because the demon is in front of God and in front of the person. You can't see it because you're looking at the demon. You're looking at the spirit. You're looking at the flesh. You move that demon, that little demon away, and then you'll see the beauty behind it. See, the devil always shows you the blessing behind the curse. But God will show you the curse behind the blessing.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Some of us get a blessing, but we don't see the curse behind it. See, Jesus will always show you the curse that's disguised as a blessing.
Uh-oh.
The devil will always show you the blessing, but he's hiding and disguising
that's
what? The curse. Y'all ain't talking to me. Y'all ain't talking to me. Y'all ain't trying to get your soul right. I'm trying to get my soul right. I'm trying to get my soul right. I was talking to the man of God. The man of God was speaking to my spirit. And I'm telling you, in the name of Jesus, it ain't the problem, it ain't your situation, it ain't your degree on the wall, it ain't your wife, it ain't your husband, it ain't your girlfriend, it ain't the car, it ain't none of that. Sometimes you just gotta get what?
My soul right!
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Stop blaming everybody for what you done did.
Come
it's
on.
All up in your soul. It ain't nobody else. Stop pointing the finger. It ain't nobody else. It's what? It's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. I ain't going to hold you. I ain't going to front. It's me, God. I'm the one. If I can just get my soul right, them demons will leave. See, when you come with the power of God in the name of Jesus, I'm telling you, you have authority and power over every demon and devil that might try to come in your life. And a demon ain't going to come in horns. It's going to come in a fleshly body.
Come on.
Denzel Washington told you it's a devil in what? A blue dress. Y'all ain't talking.
Come on.
Or a blue tie. I ain't going. Pastor, all devils ain't women. I knew that.
He said a blue dress.
What I'm saying to you is it can't always be everybody else.
Come on.
It can't always be the pastor. Pastor ain't doing nothing but preaching the word.
Amen.
I ain't right. I wish I did. I would have made some clauses and excuses for myself. Lord, this is why I'm really jacked up. And I would have wrote my way into heaven, but I can't do that. Amen. I got to get my soul right.
Amen. Amen.
That's why people try to cast out demons with no authority. You can't cast out a demon if you ain't walking in love. You can't cast out a spirit of hate if you ain't walking in love. You can't cast out bitterness if you're not walking in love. You got to first get what? Your soul right and then get the what? The demons out your life.
Thank you, Father.
Y'all quiet.
Amen.
It's the obedience that gives you power. And we're in the season where Jesus was obedient unto death. He came knowing he was going to die. He came knowing that that was his commission. That was on that was the end game. That was on his resume. His resume was he was going to be wounded for our iniquities and bruised for, and the chastisement was going to be upon us. He knew that from day one. The Bible says, let us make man in our image. And when man got messed up, Jesus knew he had to come to die. And you know the song says, if somebody's got to die, and guess what? If I go, you got to go, right? You ain't no different than me. And when I was thinking about this, I said, wow, God, how can we get our soul right? How can we get these demons out of our life? And then I looked at that and God said, Mary did it. God said, Mary did it. Mary did it. He said, look at the word. I was praying and I was fasting. I said, Lord God, you got to help me. Because I believe in 2016 is going to be the best year of our lives.
Amen.
But the first thing that's got to happen is you got to get what? My soul right. But the Bible says, David said, my soul shall make a boast in the Lord. It's all about Jesus. It's all about the presence of God. It's all about the spirit of the Lord that gives you liberty in the name of Jesus. And you got to get your soul right. That's the only thing that gives you power over the enemy.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Ooh, thank you, Lord. See, the enemy wants to threaten you. The enemy wants to torture you. That's why, woman of God, when you came in, you walked past 3 or 4 times. I saw you each time. And God wouldn't let you walk past without getting brought back into the building. And then God sent somebody out there to go get you. See, sometimes we done drifted so far away from the Word of God, somebody got to come in and rest our flesh. You ain't going to come on your own. We already know it. God already knows it. That's why he said, I'll leave the 99 to go get the one. I'm going to show you what it looks like. Stand up, man of God. Stand up and turn your back to me. Stand up. Hurry up. Come on. I ain't got all day. Turn around. See, sometimes the one has walked away, and God's got to pull you back and pull you into the house of God and stand you there, and then God's going to take every bullet for you, every dart, every fiery dart that the enemy has aimed at you. When he's got you in the building, the book's going to be bouncing off the chest of Jesus. Y'all ain't talking to me. Jesus took a bullet for some of y'all.
That's right, Jesus.
Jesus took a bullet for some of y'all, and while he's taking a bullet, you should be in the background talking about something. I got to get my soul right. I got to get these devils out of my life. Because he's taking a bullet for you.
Thank you, Lord. Yeah. Come on.
That's right, preacher. That's right, man.
I got to get what? My soul. Right.
Amen. You're on fire.
It can't be everybody else.
It can be everybody.
Yo, no, don't go to the room, man. I like your opinion, man. Hold my water, man. I got to help you pass it out. But I began to think about this. Turn to the book of Luke chapter 2. I began to think about this. And you know, y'all ain't got to sit down if y'all don't want to. You know, if you're standing in the moment. But I'm just telling you, this is a very interactive service. But when I saw the woman of God, it's important to understand that God is all about going to get his people. The Bible says, he says, in the book of John, he says, my sheep shall what? Know my voice. And another voice? They will not follow. But see, God knows that the sheep might have strayed away. So God's got to go get them. Go walk over to the door, man of God. Hurry up. Go. Walk up to the door. God's got to, the sheep may have walked away. And he knows that the sheep are vulnerable when they're by themselves.
Amen.
See, the wolf is not going to come when it's 100 sheep. He's going to come when it's one all by himself. Y'all ain't saying to him. This is why you got to dispatch angels. The Bible says in the book of Psalm chapter 91 verse 11, he said, thy angels shall have charge over thee.
Amen.
So when you have drifted away and walked away from the house of God, God's going to dispatch legions of angels saying, God, I know you won't get your soul right, but you ain't going to come on your own. So I'm going to grip you up. I'm going to mess your shirt up. I'm going to pull you into the house of God. I'm going to show you that I'm going to save you. I'm going to show you that I'm going to keep you. And then I'm going to stand in front of you and take every bullet that was aimed at your chest. Y'all ain't talking to me. Y'all got some people out there that need Jesus to stand in front of them and take a bullet for them. He said, I died for your sins. I died for your mistakes. Ain't no weapon formed against you. Don't prosper. Not because of you, because I'm standing in front of you.
Amen.
It ain't you. It ain't the S on your chest. It's me standing in front of you, blocking you and guarding you and making sure and shielding you in the name of Jesus. And if some of y'all will read Psalm 91 verse 11 and dispatch your angels around your family, around your loved ones, around your husband, around your wife, Jesus will take a bullet. And while he's taking a bullet, you better be singing that Jay-Z song. I gotta get what? My soul right. I gotta get these demons what?
Out of my life. That's right, man. Praise us.
He's
on fire.
Fire. Y'all waiting for me to mention the manger. It's coming.
Fire.
But Jesus came to destroy sin.
Fire.
Don't get it twisted. He's a lover, but he's a fighter first. He came to destroy sin. That was his commission from day one. He came to stand in front of you and take every bullet that was aimed at your chest in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Jesus comes to defend his sheep.
Amen. That's right.
How y'all feel?
Fired up.
Watch this. Look what the Bible says. Look what the Bible says. See, the Bible always talks about sheep in a very special way. And that's why he said, my sheep shall know my voice, because he understood that there are other voices out there.
Yes,
y'all
is.
Might not say that to me, but I'm telling you it's true. There's some other voices that people are listening to, and it ain't Jesus. It sound like Jesus. It might even look like Jesus. It might be disguised like Jesus. It might have a J on the M on the logo or whatever, but it ain't Jesus. He said, my sheep shall know my voice. You've got to recognize the voice of God. And even when he came in the manger, even before he was birthed in the world knew he was coming. The Bible says that that because that my sheep shall know my voice, another voice they will not follow. That also means that the sheep know his voice and that they will or they seek out to follow him. But if the sheep do stray away, the Bible says to the children, he said, train up your child in the way that what? They should go. So when they depart, they'll what?
Shall not turn away from it.
They will always come back to the word. That's because right. The sheep what? Know the voice.
Amen.
Because the sheep know the voice. See, when you understand why Jesus came, he came for the lost sheep. He came for the ones that walked away from him. He came for the brokenhearted. He came for the blind eyed. And he said, I'm going to pull you back. That's why when you walked out the house, what's your name, Ariana? That's why when you walked past 2-3 times, it was a magnetic pull that was pulling you. And I believe Rakim had a song. He said, I came through the door. I said it before, but I never let the devil terrorize me no more. Y'all ain't talking to me. He said, I'm changing the words, and I'm going to make it right for the house of God. He said, I never let the devil terrorize me no more. Some of y'all got to get fed up with that devil tormenting you sometimes. He came to destroy sin. Stop making excuses. Jesus gave you all the power from heaven and on high to destroy the works of the flesh.
Amen.
Jesus.
You preaching right past
me. But he understands it was about the sheep. He knows he came and it was about the sheep. He knows he came and it was about the sheep.
Amen.
The book of, I believe it's in the book of Psalm. The book of Psalm. Look what the book of Psalm. I believe it's in Psalm 78. Oh my God, that's what Psalm 78. Okay, here we go. Psalm 78. I believe is what I saw. Psalm 78. Look what the Bible says. Look at Psalm 78, chapter 70. Psalms is in the Old Testament. We're only going to be there for a second. But I want to show you something about the power of God and when he came. See, many of us don't understand. If you don't look at yourself and examine yourself, you won't be able to find where there's impurities in you. The impurity is not going to come out of you. You've got to examine yourself. You've got to look in the mirror. You've got to take the spiritual x-ray so you can identify what is separating me from my blessing. What is separating me from my future and from my destiny and from my purpose? And sometimes the only thing that's separating is you got this image of the flesh standing in front of you. When you look in the mirror, you see yourself. But now that's not what you're supposed to be seeing. You're supposed to be looking face to face into the eyes of God. We covered it on Wednesday in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. He said, I'm face to face with God. And the veil has been taken away from the eye. The veil has been taken away from the heart. So nothing's going to stop you from being great in God. Amen?
Amen.
The Bible says in the book of Psalm chapter 78, it says, I'm going to read in verse 70. I just want to show you one little piece to understanding how to get your soul right. How to get your soul right. The Bible says he chose David, also his servant, and he took him from guarding the sheep. That's it right there. See, some of the things that God is going to do, God is going to find out if you're close to the sheep. Whoever's close to the sheep, if you really got something good in your heart, God's going to place you around the sheep. God's going to have you doing the dirty work. God's going to have you in the vineyard. God's going to have you in the crack houses. God's going to have somebody pulling you from outside when you want to walk down the rising sun. God said, no, you don't, because what you need is right in here.
Amen.
You thought you was lost. No, you wasn't. You were just waiting for God to pull you in and yank you in the name of Jesus. The Bible says he chose David, his servant, and took him from guarding the sheep, from following the sheep with a great young. He brought them and he fed Jacob, his people, and Israel, his inheritance. Look at what verse 72 of Psalm 78 says. So he fed them according to the pureness of his heart. That was his soul. The Bible says David was a man after God's own heart. Why? Because David was trying to get his soul right. David knew he had just committed adultery. David knew he had just popped a pill. David knew he had just came out the club. David knew he had just finished drinking. David knew he had just finished sleeping around. But he said, what? I got to get my soul right. See, that's the kind of man or woman that God loves. God wants somebody to stand up in front of the whole church. I don't care what y'all think about me. I got to get my soul right. Because it ain't about you. It ain't about none of y'all in this room. It's about me and God. And I got to get my soul right. Because he said light and darkness cannot exist in the same place.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The Bible says, so he fed them according to the pureness of his heart. Psalm 78, verse 72. He said he fed. See, he knew that David had just finished killing Uriah, Bathsheba's husband, and he knew David wasn't right. There's no way David could dwell with God walking in adultery. The devil is a liar.
Yes,
some people talking about some, I'm in adultery, I want that man, and you know he got another girl. The devil is a liar. God ain't gonna give you somebody else's. God is not down with OPP. God is not down with OPP. Y'all remember that song, you down with OPP? Yeah, you know me, the devil is a liar. I don't want nobody else's property. I want what belongs to me. Get your hands off of my stuff, devil. That belongs to me in the name of Jesus. And that's when Jesus came. He came to destroy the works of the flesh. But he said, you got to get what? Your soul right.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Y'all all right?
Yeah.
He said, so David fed them according to the integrity or the pureness of his heart. The only way you can get a pure heart, man, of God, you gotta purify that thing. You gotta let that thing out. Sometimes you got to cry. Sometimes you got to weep. Sometimes you got to stay up all night. The Bible says even Jesus, what? The Bible says David knew he was filled with sin. He was filthy, dirty rags. David was a liar, a cheat, a murderer, a killer. But he started getting his soul right. And as soon as he got his soul right, and them demons started what? Getting out his life. Y'all ain't talking to me. I'm telling you, when Jesus came, he came to destroy the works of the flesh.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
That's why he said he's the son of David. Because his soul was right.
Amen.
Y'all looking at me kind of strange.
Preacher.
Can I give y'all one more scripture?
Amen.
I need somebody else up here. Man of God, step off for a second. Why don't you feel inspired? He's all good. Come on, come on. Come on. See, that's what I'm talking about. I'm trying to get married. Come on. Give me some love. Come on. I got to get what?
My soul.
I got to get these demons what?
All my life.
Come on. I got to get what?
All my life.
Y'all ain't talking to me. It's nothing better than a changed man.
Let's go.
It ain't nothing better than a changed man walking with God, loving God. Y'all ain't standing to your feet, because y'all don't really want to tell you. It ain't nothing better than when a man changes his life. It's so right.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
I said, looking in the mirror like, what have I become? Look at you, boy. He's smoking out your lungs. Killing brain cells and your lips getting black, but when you got a strong addiction, how you getting rid of that? It don't make it no better than my mind like the race. I think highly of myself but still feel out of place. It's confusing. That's when the devil like to abuse him. When he in that mind state, he feel as though he can use him.
Use him, God.
Not me. Oh no, I'm way too strong. I got stress on my chest, but still I carry on.
Come on.
Look at my body, examining my self-inflicted wounds. I ain't tripping. Jesus won't scab him up soon. Take success. Use it as my cocoa butter. I got focus so I can get these local duckies. I do it clean. I ain't worried about no popo coming.
Come on.
Say to myself, I ain't worried about no fofo busting. The devil sent his wolves at me and I still ain't shaking.
Woo! Come on.
Come on.
He said
he's thrown on my back and I still ain't breaking.
Come on.
I know my God looking at me like, look at my young buck. His back against the wall and he's still not giving up.
Come on! Come on, man, God!
I had voices in my head chanting, you've been saved. I don't take that for granted, but I still ain't paid. Rage consumes my heart, thinking minimum wage. I'm a slave and God about to break me out of this cage.
Come on.
Come on!
Jerry.
Come on now, that ain't none of that plan, y'all. I said, man, dude got bars. That's what I'm talking about.
Get my soul right.
You gotta get what?
My soul right.
I gotta get what?
My soul right.
Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty.
Amen.
Jesus.
Use of God.
Come on.
Use the people's talents.
Yes.
Use the skills and talents of the building. Rel is coming next. Rel is coming next. Come on.
Yes.
Come on, ain't nothing better when somebody trying to get their soul right. Y'all ain't talking to me. David said I gotta get what? My soul right. David said I gotta get what? My soul right. I don't care what you're looking at, I gotta get what? My soul right. I don't care how long I've been stuck in sin, I gotta get what? My soul right. I don't care how crazy it look getting out, I'ma get what? My soul right. I don't care if you laugh at me, I'ma get what? My soul right. I don't care if they look like at me like I'm crazy. Guess what? I'ma get what?
My soul right.
What?
My soul right.
Yeah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You like that, West Philly?
Yeah.
I wish you could plan this.
Amen.
Woo.
But Jesus came to destroy that. That's why he said that the enemy's on my back and he still ain't breaking. Don't you know the devil did everything he could to break everyone in this room?
Yes, he did.
He did everything he could to break you. He did everything he could to make you bend. He did everything you could to make you stay out the house of God. He did everything you could to make you swallow that pill. He did everything you could to drink that drink. Y'all ain't talking to me. He did everything you could to not stab that man. He did everything. He tried all he could to make you go get in adultery. He tried to make you snap. He tried to make you cry. He tried to make you give up. Y'all ain't talking to me. Maybe y'all ain't never felt like giving up. I'm telling you, I've been there and I've done that. I'm telling you, he did everything he could to make you lose your mind. But you got to get what?
My soul right.
Jesus.
That's your problem. We always worry about what everybody else thinks. No, I'm going to get what I need today. And ain't none of y'all going to stop me. I'm going to get what I got to get. That's what Mary said. Mary walked up to Elizabeth. And as soon as she spoke to Elizabeth, what happened? That Holy Ghost hit Elizabeth. The baby started doing backflips inside of her belly. That's what the Bible says. I didn't write it. As soon as Mary opened her mouth, she spoke the word of God. I'm going to show it to you in a minute. And some of y'all, if you would just open your mouth and say, I got to get what?
My soul right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah,
Jesus. I was thinking about
everybody.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, y'all ain't talking to me.
Yes,
thank you, Father. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. I need your help.
Amen.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Woo. Gotta get what?
My soul right.
Gotta get what? These demons what?
Soul.
Out my life.
Yes.
Woo, Jesus. God is good, ain't he?
Yes.
Amen.
Come on, I'm going to show it to you. Watch this. Look at what the Bible says. Let me get that pink Bible. Turn to the book of Luke chapter 1. I'm going to show you right here in the Word. Go to Luke chapter 1 in the name of Jesus. Yeah, we're going to get right today. We're going to get right today. Oh, yeah, we're going to get right today. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God is good. I feel the spirit right here in the building in the name of Jesus. I spirit. I feel it. I feel it. Leave it right there. Good. Amen. Thank you, baby. You look so good. I had to get my soul right to get my baby. Y'all ain't going to say that. But she almost left me about 20 years ago. I said, baby, you ain't going nowhere. And it ain't because you look good. It ain't only because you look good. You look good. But I know it was a Jesus trapped up in there. I know when she was going to serve the Lord in the name of Jesus. See, her soul is more valuable than her beauty in the name of Jesus. She got the beauty. But when the Bible says a woman that fears the Lord shall get everything that she deserves. Y'all ain't talking to me. I ain't worried about your beauty. I'm worried about do you fear the Lord? Do you serve God? Are you trying to get what?
Your soul right.
Come on. Come on.
Thank you, Jesus.
All them curves and all that don't mean nothing. All that lingerie, that don't mean nothing. Everybody wear it. Everybody got a hole. Everybody got breasts. It all for the same. For the woman that fears the Lord, that'll help you get what?
Your soul right.
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
You think some Muslim dude gonna be touching up on my wife? No, I'm gonna get my soul right, and I'm gonna get these devils out of my life and hers.
Amen.
Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I'm preaching now. I'm preaching. Don't worry about it.
Yes, you are. Hallelujah.
The Bible says, "What profit a man to gain the whole world and lose what?
His soul."
Y'all ain't talking to me. What does it mean to have all the money if you lose what?
Your soul.
I gotta get what? My soul right. And get these demons what?
Out of my life.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
For all my newcomers, I preach kind of different. But it's all good. I'm still using the word of God. It's good.
Amen.
But if you come in the house of God and your soul ain't right, there's a problem. Don't leave the same way you came.
Amen.
You got to change. The Bible says he preached repentance, which is what? Change. He said, I got to get what? My soul right.
Woo!
Thank you.
Yes, yes.
Woo.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you,
thank you, God.
And usually when God is trying to get your soul right, God will do it when you sleep. Because he know you can't fight and put up resistance. He know you can't talk back to him. You can't make excuses. You can't talk your way out of it.
Amen.
Lord God, I'm angry because he made me angry. The devil is a liar. That angry demon is already inside of you. You got to get what? Your soul right. Ain't nobody push your buttons. Ain't nobody rub you the wrong way. Ain't nobody step on your blue suede shoes. You ain't got no blue suede shoes. You know they came from Payless. He said you got to get what? Your soul right.
Woo, it's going down in here.
Woo, that's right.
Come on,
man. It ain't nothing wrong with getting your soul right.
Come on.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Ain't nothing wrong.
I don't see nothing wrong.
Come on, come on.
That's it. Forget the rest of the song.
Hallelujah.
Pastor, you told me to get my soul right. Now you're telling me to go bump and grind. The devil is a liar. I ain't say that.
They're
going to
run real quick.
Yeah, they want to hear half the sermon. Pastor said, hey, I don't see nothing wrong. And they're going to go get Jimmy and go get Jezebel. Well, Pastor will come back on your door. The devil is a liar. You better get your soul right.
Come on,
get it out. And you might not answer the door, but I'm going to keep what? Knocking. You might be up there bumping and grinding, but I'm going to do what? I'm going to keep knocking. You won't come up out of here, Jezebel, in the name of Jesus. Because why are you sleeping with a man that you don't want anyway? You know you ain't going to marry him, lose him, and let him go!
Jesus!
You better preach when you don't want to preach!
No!
Woo!
Y'all all right? Actually, that'll be one of the next turns. I gotta get my soul right. I gotta get these devils out of my life. But guess what? You in the right place to do it.
Amen.
We all been there.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
He said, all have fallen short of the glory of God. Not just me. It ain't just me. You can look at me like I'm crazy, but it ain't just me. The Bible says all have fallen short. There was no reason for him, for Noah, to build the ark. It wasn't because they needed a boat. He knew that all had fallen short of the glory of God. It wasn't nothing but Noah's family. Y'all ain't talking to me. I'm telling you, I need that Noah spirit. I want the spirit of the ark in the name of Jesus. Lord, I got to get my soul right. Let me get on the boat in the name of Jesus.
Let me get on the boat.
Thank you for your
peace.
Jesus in the building.
Our hats off.
Thank you for your song.
Yeah. Come on.
Amen. Thank you, God.
I gotta get what?
My soul right.
Thank you, God.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Now you're standing up, man. God, that's what I like, see?
Amen. Mm.
That's what I'm talking about. God, the Bible's no respect of persons.
Amen.
If I go. You got to go.
Amen.
If you want to walk in signs, wonders, and miracles, you got to crucify your flesh.
Amen.
There ain't no other way to do it.
Jesus.
You got to crucify and mortify the deeds of the flesh. That means you got to get what? Your soul right.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Watch this. Let me try to get on out your way. Come on, stay with me. Well, I said, go to the book of Luke chapter 1.
Yes.
I'm going to walk you through this real quick. And then I'm going to get on out your way. How much time I got?
What do you need?
29. That's one. Okay, amen. I got a few minutes. Come on. Where's my save section at? Take your time, Pastor. How much time I got?
Take your time, Pastor.
How much?
Take your time, Pastor.
The Broncos ain't playing now.
Take your time, Pastor.
Eagles have to play, y'all. The Broncos are playing tomorrow. We got all day. And you won't come up in here with a black and gold. I'm telling you, listen, if I love you so much, we have a problem. But guess what? I gotta get my soul. Oh, hats off. I'll give credit to what credit is due. Oh, hats off. The book of Luke chapter 1. And I'm gonna get on out your way. See, when Jesus came and said, it's important that you have to understand that you're going to have to use your voice to get free.
Amen.
You're going to have to use your voice.
Your voice.
You talking about something I had a praying grandmother?
Nah,
I'm telling you, you got to use your voice. Grandma can't do everything for you. Grandma can't pull you out of jail. Grandma can't pull you out of the hospital. Grandma can't do everything. Grandma can't pull you out of Jimmy's bed. You got to open up your mouth, lift up your voice, and declare, I want to be free. I got to get right, my soul right.
Thank you. Come on. Thank you. You got to use Jesus. Your voice. Amen. Yes.
Use the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's how you get free. The Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 16, the Bible said that Paul and Silas were in jail, and they were stuck up in jail, and they began to open up their mouth. They began to sing unto the Lord. They began to declare their freedom. They began to declare their victory in the name of Jesus. And what did the Bible say happened to the jail cell? The jail began to shake, and then the door began to open, and then they got their freedom. You got to lift up your voice and say, Lord, I got to get what? My soul. It's me, oh Lord. Standing in the need of prayer.
Yes. Me,
O Lord. The Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 1, verse 37, and it's something I wanted to preach and teach to you about Mary. See, Mary, in the Bible, Mary said very few words in the Bible. Mary's only got about three speaking parts inside the movie. If this was a movie, Mary would have been a big character in the Bible.
Amen.
Jesus.
If this were a movie, Mary would have been a big character. She would have had the smallest lines. Mary said very few things in the Bible, but when she opened her mouth, oh, y'all ain't gonna say nothing to me. When Mary opened her mouth, she said some of the most powerful words ever known inside the Word of God.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Luke chapter 1, verse 37. The Bible says, for with God, nothing shall be impossible. I don't care what it look like. I don't care what it feel like. I don't care how long you've been mad. I don't care how long you've been depressed. I don't care how long you done had that financial issue. With God, the Bible says, nothing shall be impossible. And look at what Mary said. The Bible says Mary walked up to Elizabeth, and Mary said, behold, the handmaiden of the Lord, be it unto me, or it seems to me, according to the word of God. Mary wasn't fussing. Mary wasn't cussing. Some of us got some cussing mouths right up in the house of God. We can't stop cussing people out. Somebody cut us off, we cuss them out. Somebody do something to them, we cuss them out. And yeah, it didn't come out your mouth, but it was in your spirit. You got to get what? Your soul right. The Bible says I can hear the spirit of man. Mary had very few words, but when she opened her mouth, the Bible says that Mary arose in those days, and she went into the hill country inside the city of Judah, and she entered into the house of Zacharias, and she began to salute Elizabeth. That's why we say all hats off, because we're saluting you. She began to greet Elizabeth, and look at what happened when Mary first opened her mouth, talking about getting your soul right. It said, and it came to pass, when Elizabeth heard the voice of Mary, that the baby leaped up inside her womb. I'm telling y'all, some of y'all got the power of Mary and the voice of Mary. When you speak out of your mouth, babies will start leaping. Finances will start leaping. Joy will start leaping. Y'all ain't talking to me. Y'all might not really want it. I'm telling you, that spirit that's upon you will start leaping off of you in the name of Jesus. When you start opening up your mouth, everything is subject to your voice.
Amen. Amen.
Everything is subject to your voice. That's why I put my mortgage inside my Bible. That's why I put my tithes inside my Bible. That's why I put my water bill inside my Bible. That's why I got some of y'all mortgages in my Bible. Because I believe in the name of Jesus, when I open up my voice and I speak to my bills are going to start leaping. My finances are going to start increasing. Because I'm going to open up my voice just like Mary did. With God, all things are possible. But first you got to do what? Get your
soul right.
Now leave it there, man of God. Because we won't step. I ain't got no mortgage. I ain't got no more. I'm speaking that thing in the name of Jesus. I dare some of y'all to come up here. I dare some of y'all to don't step on your mortgage. Come on up. Come on up. You better go step on your bills. Come on. Come on. I gotta get what? My soul right. And I'm gonna get them devils what? Out my life. I want that from you. Step on that. Come on, come on, step again. Step again, come on, come on.
Hallelujah.
I gotta get what? My soul right.
Come on, it's over.
Over.
Right, right, right.
Thank you.
Come on.
Come on, I got 2 minutes. Can y'all give me a couple more minutes? Come on. Come on, look at the man of God. Look at him, look at him, look at him. Step on it, step on it. Step on it. Come on. In the name of Jesus, you better loose that thing and let the bills go. In Jesus' name. That's what I'm talking about. Reduce all your debts. In the name of Jesus, I'm getting these devils, these debt demons out of my life. If you got a mortgage, you should be up here stepping on your mortgage. Did you come up here, Terry? Oh, amen. Come on. Come on, Kathleen. Step on that. Step on that.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Lord.
I don't know if this is a lozenge or a breath mint. You try to say my breath stink? She said, Pastor, get your breath right. I'm joking.
Hallelujah.
You got the mic, you can do anything.
Hallelujah.
Y'all don't understand what I'm talking about.
Yes,
the Bible says when Mary opened up her voice, she didn't do nothing. She didn't even have to lay hands. She opened up her voice and she said, in the name of Jesus, according to the word of God, I'm going to speak to my finances. I'm going to speak to my debt. I'm going to speak to my marriage. I'm going to speak to my joy. I'm going to speak to my peace. I'm going to speak to my husband. I'm going to speak to my wife. I'm going to speak to my job. I got to get what? My soul. Come on, loose it, loose it, loose it, loose it. All mortgages are being paid in the name of Jesus. I decree it, I declare it in the name of Jesus. I'm getting this debt demon out of my life. Debt, you got to go. Fear, you got to go. Sickness, you got to go. Power, you got to go. I've got to get my soul.
Jesus.
If you got a debt, now's the time that God is releasing supernatural debt eradication in the name of Jesus. And I'm not taking up no offering. I don't want none of your money. All I want you to do is believe and get what? Your soul right.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm not going to be up here hustling no money. I don't want a dollar from you. All I want you to do is believe God. Just get your soul right and speak the word of God. Do what Mary said. Mary walked up to Elizabeth and she said, well, God, all things are possible. I don't care what it looked like. I don't care what it feel like. If you just get your soul right, I'm telling you, there's some things that's getting ready to change inside your life. Fears get ready to leave. Doubts get ready to leave. Mortgages are getting ready to get paid. If you would just open your mouth and say, Lord, I gotta get my soul right.
Jesus.
Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on. Jesus. Come on.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus. Supernatural debt eradication is happening right now. Yes. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. I'm telling you, I'm not hustling you for nothing. I don't want a single red cent. The Bible said the woman with 2 pennies gave more than everybody because she was walking by faith. If you got 2 pennies, I'll take that because that's telling me what kind of faith you got. The Bible says she gave more than all the rich people in the name of Jesus. I don't want no dollar. If you got 2 cents, pull it out your pocketbook in the name of Jesus. Put it in your hand and say, Lord, I got to get my soul right. And this is all I got. And if I only got 2 pennies, I'm going to bring it and I'm going to give it as an offering in the name of Jesus, because I know when I speak the power and the word of God. Them demons, the demons and devils in my life, they got to go because my soul is anchored inside the Lord.
Yes, man.
Woo!
Some of us don't want it bad enough. I don't want no mortgage. I don't want to owe nobody nothing. The Bible says, owe no man nothing but love. That's all I want to do. All I want to do is love you. All I want to do is pour my love into you. That's the new weapon in the new season. I'm going to pour my love down. And the Bible says, it's love that covers the multitude of what?
Sin.
But I got to get what?
My soul right.
Some of y'all don't know what it takes to get up here and preach. Some of y'all don't know what kind of attack's gonna happen. See, guess what? It ain't just you. I gotta get it right too. I gotta stand before the Lord. I gotta give an account for myself. Lord, I gotta get my soul right. I know I ain't got it all together. That man that left you, I'm telling you, in the name of Jesus, when he get his soul right, I'm telling you, it's gonna be all good when he come on back. Cause he gonna get his soul right. It ain't nothing that's gonna do it. Let him get his soul right. I speak today in the name of Jesus that he get his soul right. I speak the same thing for you, woman of God. Anybody else in the house that been hurt, I'm telling you, if people would just get their soul.
Thank you, Lord.
Hey, man.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you,
my soul is anchored in the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Mary said very few words. But the Bible says what she did say was according to the word of the Lord. It was according to the word of the Lord. She says in verse 42, she spoke with a loud voice. She spoke with what? A loud voice. She said, blessed art thou, woman. And blessed is the fruit of thy womb. I'm telling you in the name of Jesus, if you would just open up your mouth with a loud voice today in the house of God and say, I gotta get what? My soul right. And I gotta get these demons what? Out my life. You gotta speak with a loud voice. The devil got hearing aids. You gotta speak loud to him. Devil, you won't get out of my house. Devil, you won't get off my daughters. You won't get off my ex-wife. In the name of Jesus, the devil gonna loose your daughter. In Jesus' name, he's gonna loose all four of them, all five of your kids. In the name of Jesus, when you open up your mouth with a loud voice and say, I gotta get what? My soul right.
I gotta get these devils out of my life. Yeah. Before I lock them for my whole life.
I'm done.
I said I gotta get my soul right before I'm locked up for my whole life. Somebody want their soul to rise. I gotta get these demons out my life. I gotta get my soul right. I gotta get these devils out of my life. Before I'm locked up for my whole life. Somebody want their soul to rise. I gotta get my soul right, before I'm locked up for my whole life, somebody want their soul to rise,
Jesus,
get out my life,
Hallelujah.
If you need to touch and agree on anything before you leave, if you need to step on any of your bills, I'm not asking you for nothing. I want you to believe in your heart and confess it with your mouth.
Amen.
That you believe that God can do exceedingly and abundantly above whatever you ask or whatever you think.
Amen.
If you have somebody in your house, if you got somebody in your job, if you got somebody that you love and you need to pull them back, you want to reduce your debt. You want to reduce your fear. You want to reduce unbelief in your life. I'm telling you, just come near the altar. Just come. Just walk by. We won't touch your hand. Just touch by. We won't touch and agree. Come on. Just lift your hands up. Lift your hands up.
Jesus.
Come on. Come on. We're going into a new season. We got new weapons. God is bringing deliverance and healing. But we got to get our soul right. There's no other way to do it. Lift your hands, Olivia. Come on. We got to get our soul right. We got to get our soul right. God said, I can do exceedingly and abundantly above whatever you ask or whatever you think. Lord, I want to get my soul right now. Lord, I need a change in 2016. But I know the only way I can do it is to get my soul right. There's no other way to do it. And I'm not going to act like it's for everybody else. I know it's me. I know I'm looking at you, but I know it's me. I know I'm pointing at you, but I know it's me. I know I said it was you, but I know it's me. I know I thought it was you, but I know it's me. I know I thought it was everybody else, but I know it's me. I know I'm the one that needs it. And I'm not ashamed of the gospel, because the gospel is life unto those that believe, but it is foolishness to those that do not.
Amen.
So I will believe your gospel, and your gospel says it could be me. I could be the one that needs to get his soul right. But God, you said if I do, you said if I will confess with my mouth and believe it in my heart, that everything that is not like you, you would begin to leave and get out of my what? My life. And Lord, I'm not going to act like it's anybody else in this room. I know it's me. I know it hurts when I look in the mirror, but I know it's me. I know some of the reasons some things didn't work is because it was me.
Amen.
I know I blamed it on her or him or you, but I know it was me. If you could just open your mouth and say, Lord, I've got to get my soul right. I've got to get my soul right. Oh God, I thank you. Oh God, I thank you. God, I thank you. My soul is crying out right now. Some of y'all need to just close your eyes and let your soul cry out to the Lord. And whatever you cry out for, God is going to answer you. Whatever you cry out for, God is going to answer. If you would just get your soul.
It's not presence.
Father, I pray, Lord God, as we leave this place, but never your presence, that we would get our soul right today. Father, I pray, God, that we would have the voice of Mary.
And what you gonna say?
Just say, Lord, give me the voice of Mary. That when I speak, things begin to change. Things begin to change. Things begin to change. But the first thing I need to do is I gotta get my soul right. And for all that, God, I give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah.
Bring somebody.
Amen.